Dear student, due to coronavirus, school started online classes for your study. So you can subscribe Golden Flower Palia YouTube channel, like and press the bell icon.
Hello students, in today's video lecture we are going to discuss about some more properties of P block elements. And still we are not talking about any particular group. We are talking about the properties of all the elements those are present in P block, and we are finding the common trend of these properties and looking for some common trend of the properties, because it is going to be applied to every element of the P block. Okay, so to understand the elements of every group, we must know these properties. Understood. So let us start with the today's topic, and today we are going to discuss about metallic and non-metallic character. Already we have discussed in the last video lecture, and in that lecture I have told you when we are talking about the metallic character of the P block elements, we can see that the metallic character, it is going to be increased down the group and it is going to be decrease along the period. If we are talking about the character, metallic character, it is what? The element, if it is easy for an element to donate the electron, it is more metallic. If it is difficult to donate the electron, instead of donating, it is accepting the electron. So we call that element as a non-metal. Okay, so this is the basic difference between the metal and non-metal. So far we have studied from the previous classes. Okay, so what is metallic? What is the common trend of the metallic and non-metallic character in the P block element? It is going to be increase top to bottom in a group, and it is going to be decrease when we are moving from left to right in a period. Okay, so what we get from this metallic and non-metallic character? And before that, studying what we are getting from metallic and non-metallic character, we must know how many are there metal and how many they are non-metals and metalloids. Okay, once again I'm going to write all the elements of the P block, and we will try to understand how many are metallic and how many are non-metallic and how many are metalloids. Okay, so let's write the elements first. We have group number 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 and 18. So this is boron, aluminium, gallium, indium, thallium. Okay, this is carbon, silicon, germanium, tin and lead, and nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, bismuth. And what is 16? Oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium, polonium. And it is fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine and astatine. And 18th group I am here writing helium above it. And here it is neon, argon, krypton, xenon and radon. So now we have these elements of group number 13 to 18. Okay, and out of these elements, how many of them are metal, how many of them are non-metal and how many are metalloids? So I'm going to make a circle of metalloids first. Okay, because all three kind of elements are present in the P block, that is why their chemistry is quite different from the other element. Like if we are talking about the transition element, there is only three elements which is not transition, but they have kept there. And except all that having the same kind of properties, and S block elements are also having all kind of metals they have, but the P block elements are having metal, non-metal and metalloid. Okay, all three kinds of elements are present in the P block. Okay, so we must understand first how many elements are there, those we call as metalloids. So these elements we find as metalloids. Okay, these are common metalloids of the elements, and above all these elements, they are non-metal, and this corner, whatever the elements are left out, they are called metals. Okay, so these are metal, these are metalloids and these are non-metals. So this round one, the circle one compounds, circle one elements are metalloids. Okay. So the student, they are making different kind of oxides, and what kind of oxides non-metal makes? Non-metals make oxides which are acidic in nature or which are neutral in nature. Like if we are talking about the oxides of carbon, phosphorus, sulfur. So these kind of oxides are acidic in nature. When we are adding these oxides into water, they are forming acids. Okay. So they are acidic in nature or they are neutral in nature. Okay. But if we are talking about the oxides of these metallic compounds, these metallic elements, if they are making their oxides, they are quite basic in nature. Okay. And what kind of the nature of the oxides of these elements? Those are metalloid. They are amphoteric inside. So amphoteric nature, their oxides having amphoteric nature, and their oxides having basic nature, and their oxides are having acidic or neutral nature. Okay, they are having neutral nature. So if we talk about the common trend of the basic character or acidic character of the oxides of element of P blocks along the period and downside the group, so how we should see that how it is going to be changed if we are talking about the acidic character of the oxides and basic character of the oxides. Okay, so one thing you have to keep in your mind, one thing you have to remember always, if more will be the electropositive metal, if the metal is more electropositive, their basic character will be more. If it is more electronegative, their basic character it is least, and acidic character it is more. Okay, so let's see how the trend of the oxides of these element it is going to be changed. Whether they are acidic or whether we are talking about the basic character of their oxides. So as we are moving from 13 to 18 group, that is left to right in a period, so electropositive character of the elements are going to be decrease, and electronegative character it is going to be increase. Okay, so if we are moving from left to right in a period, electronegativity is increasing, so the acidic character of their oxide it is going to be increased. And top to bottom, if we are talking about the acidic nature of these oxides, so top to bottom electropositive character of the element it is increasing, electronegativity is decreasing. So here the common trend we can see that the acidic character of the oxides of these elements it is going to be decrease. Okay, or if we see the same trend in the basic character, so here acidic character was increasing, so basic character is obviously decreasing. So top to bottom also the basic character it is increasing. Okay, so we just are talking about oxides, the acidic character or basic character of oxides of the elements of P block. So acidic character from left to right in a period it is increases of oxides, and basic character decreases. And same for if we are talking general trend in the group from top to bottom, so acidic character it is going to be decrease of their oxides, and basic character it is going to be increase. Okay students, so this is the acidic or basic character, and that we should see from the metallic and non-metallic nature of the elements. Have you understood this one? So now we have to talk about some more, that is the first element of each group of the P block elements. If we see that the electronic configuration of first element of each group, it is different from the other elements. How it is different? Like if we are talking about it's boron, this is carbon 6, nitrogen 7, oxygen 8, fluorine 9, it is 10. And we should see that electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. and 1s2, 2s2, 2p3, 1s2, 2s2, 2p4, 1s2, 2s2, 2p5. Okay, we should see the last electron is going to be enter into the p subshell. So how many orbitals are there in the valence shell? How many orbitals are there? 1 is 2s and 3 are there in 2p. Okay, so 3 are there in 2p. If we fill these electrons 2s and 2p. Okay, so there are only 2 orbitals vacant. So up to what extent it can expand its electronic configuration? So it can expand its electronic configuration up to 4, okay, till here, because it has only 4 orbitals available. Okay, so it can expand its electronic configuration up to 4 orbital. So there, what maximum covalency can be raised? That is up to 4. Okay, that is why if we see the elements carbon and phosphorus, okay, if we see the elements of nitrogen and phosphorus, nitrogen's chloride, it is NCl3, and phosphorus, it is having PCl3 and PCl5 also. Why NCl5 is not existing here? Why N nitrogen is not having pentachloride? It doesn't show pentachloride. Only phosphorus can show pentachloride. So let's try to understand this question, the electronic configuration of phosphorus also. So phosphorus is having 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p and 3p3. Okay, so this is 6 and 4, 10, 10 and 5, 15. Okay, so 3p3 and there is 3d also. Okay, 3d is also available. The d orbital of suitable energy is available here with the phosphorus. So phosphorus can expand its electronic configuration of the valence shell in the d orbital also. So here it was 3s and the 3p. And the 3D is having 5, okay, it is having 5 orbitals, sorry, 4 are made already, it is having 5, it is having 3, so 3s2, 3p3, so this one electron, it can promote to the D orbital, so there could be maximum covalency up to 5. So it can make PCl5 also. Okay, it can take one electron from the chlorine atom and 5 chlorine atom can be joined to the phosphorus. But nitrogen is having only 4 orbitals. Okay, it can expand its electronic configuration maximum up to 4. Covalency, the maximum limit of the covalency is up to 4. But we have only 3 unpaired electrons. So whatever number of unpaired electron is available with the atom, only that much number of atom it can join with. Okay, only that much number of chlorine atom it can join with the nitrogen. So nitrogen was having only 3 electrons, unpaired electrons available. So only 3 chlorine atom can be joined with the nitrogen. But instead of that, if we are talking about phosphorus, so phosphorus is existing, the phosphorus chloride, it is existing in 2 categories, PCl3 and PCl5. So both it can be shown. If only 3 electrons unpaired it is there, so it will show a PCl3. If it can promote one of the 3s electron into the 3d orbital, it can show PCl5 also. So the first element of each group, it is like that. They are showing the different compound, the other elements are showing the different kind of compound. Okay, so we can say there, the first element is little bit different from the other element because they are not having d orbital of suitable energy to expand their electronic configuration of the valence shell. So the first difference, it is the first element of each group, it is different from the other group, from the other element of the group, because it is not having the d orbital, unavailability of the d orbital of suitable energy. We will call it suitable energy because d orbital is already present, but it is not suitable energy, it is not of suitable energy. The s electron cannot be shifted, the low energy electron cannot be shifted to very high energy orbital. Okay, so this you must have to understand, that the d orbitals of suitable energy are not available with these elements of every first element of the group of p block elements. So this is the first difference. Second difference, the first element is having higher electronegativity. As we move down the group, electronegativity is decreasing. So electron gaining tendency, it is more. So the first element is having higher electronegativity. They are having higher ionization enthalpy. So these are the three differences which make it different from the other element. So some of the properties are not resembling of these elements with the other elements. Is that clear? So some kind of compound, the other element are showing, but this element is not showing. Okay, so this you have to keep remember, that the first element of each group, it is different from the other group due to the three reasons. The first reason is vacant d orbitals of suitable energy are absent. Okay, and the second thing, it is high electronegativity, and third is high ionization enthalpy, and fourth it is small size. Okay, instead of this high ionization enthalpy, you can take small size. Okay, so three properties are quite necessary, which makes the first element of each group different from the other element. Thus it doesn't show the same kind of compound the other element are making. Okay, that is why the first element of each group, it is different.
Do self-study at home and stay home, save lives.